let's move to LeBron James, who, in my opinion, is still struggling to explain why he abandoned his hometown and base to move to Los Angeles. Yesterday, James's agent, Rich Paul, took a crack at offering an explanation.
It was just a basketball decision. You know, I think it was one of the biggest challenges this year. When he went to Miami, it was about winning the championship. When he came home, it was about delivering a promise. This one, he really had no footing. It was basically about what he wanted to do and what made him happy. People say, well, it's about movies, it's about this. It's LeBron James. He's already he's already a global entity.
Okay, so it was a basketball decision, but he really had no footing. It was a basketball decision, but James just did what he wanted to do and what made him happy, but it was a basketball decision. Look, when Pac moved to LA, it was about getting in the studio with Dr. Dre and representing for Suge and Death Row. Biggie came here for the weather, women, and weed. LeBron either doesn't know or doesn't want to explain why he loaded up his truck and moved to Beverly Hills, that is, swimming pools, movie star. That's why Brentwood Braun won't hold a press conference. He doesn't want to admit the main thing is no longer the main thing. Basketball is not the center of his universe. He's here to hang out with DiCaprio, Pacino, and Snoop. He's here to chase celebrity, not rings. He's here to be bigger than basketball. I'm not convinced it's going to work. I'm not convinced it's going to work out. I'm not sure if Laker fans are going to be satisfied with the table scraps a 34-year-old LeBron feeds them after nights on the town with Hollywood elites. Basketball is not the main thing, and that's going to be a problem.
I don't think basketball is the only thing. I don't know if it's not the main thing. I just don't think it's the only thing. I don't think it's a bad thing to want to continue to diversify your portfolio. Meanwhile, in fairness to LeBron, wherever he's gone, he has in fact won. And based upon how he's always taken care of his body, he has a longer shelf life than anybody we've seen try and carry the NBA. So, like, listen, you're not wrong in that I'm sure he likes being not being the only celebrity in town. That gets uncomfortable. I'm sure his family likes living here. I'm sure it does diversify the portfolio of his brand, not just Blaze Pizza and Beats by Dre, but movies and music and such and such. But being the guy on the floor at Staples Center is still what it's about. It's the reason that he came here, and it's what Magic is one of the only
people
on Earth.
Hold the press conference and tell me that then.
I think he will in time.
He's still a 34-year-old man with no signs of showing down, not yet. He came here, he's going to compete. He's going to add 13 to 16-plus wins to this roster. He's going to win at a high level. He's going to make the playoffs. He's the early favorite for the MVP this season. And it is still more than the game. He's more than an athlete. It's more than basketball. He's doing that.
It's no not one like can the, explain
but it's not
why
like
he's
the
here,
old
Caron.
NBA. It's not like the old NBA where you just say, look, you just play basketball, stick to that, and don't have outside ventures and things like that. Like you say, he's diversifying his portfolio. He's doing other things, but he's still priority is basketball.
I'd like to start with the word disappointment. Can you explain, like, what is a disappointment for LeBron in L.A.?
I think anything less than two titles during his four years here.
Oh, my.
Wow. Well, I think he learned his lesson
anything
in Miami.
Anything less than two titles. This is L.A. When the all-time... How many did Kareem get when he was here? Magic.
Different how many
times?
Years was Kareem here?
Different times.
Ever.
I'm talking about what the
prime.
Expectations
are. But he was
also
here in his prime. And he was also surrounded by Hall
Magic
of Famers.
Worthy.
And that's why
Magic
I
Worthy, Byron Scott,
they're
Michael
going
Thompson.
To be disappointed. This is Wilt Chamberlain all over again. Will came here for 5 years at the end of his career.
Will wasn't ever a winner. He had won one before he got here. Will was not a winner. Okay, don't compare Wilt Chamberlain, who put up all kinds of records, but always failed at the highest level, to LeBron James, who is setting records, but has been arguably the best
player.
He's won
three times. He's won three times. I'll give him that.
Let's back up, though.
He's got one more title than Wilt Chamberlain, but continue.
Let's back up,
who had to face the Boston Celtics and an all-star lineup every time he went to the finals. But I
the last 5 years,
everybody that dribble right.
What have the Lakers done? What have they done last 5 years? What have the Lakers done? Nothing. Absolutely. They're irrelevant. They don't matter. The L.A. Rams, okay? The L.A. Kings. There are many teams in this market overshadowing the Lakers the last 5 years.
Please,
no,
please,
the Lakers have been irrelevant completely, Doug.
Please,
they can't win 35 games.
Rams.
Okay, you're winning
silly.
Titles,
I know
and
you
the Lakers
got,
are struggling. They've been awful for 5 years.
Here,
I'm telling I've only been out here 2 years, but I'm saying... You bring LeBron, you are now the biggest show in town without question. You're the biggest show in the NBA. They're going to lead the league in TV appearances. The Lakers are going to run this town with LeBron. They're back to relevance.
The headline and the story.
Yeah, and now, Whitlock, you know that in life and in sports, you don't just go for Hail Mary passes every time. You go for incremental gains, slowly move the ball down the field, 3 yards in a cloud of dust. The Patriots move slowly. He's going to work in the new guys. He's going to see what these one-year dudes, Rondo and Lance, can do. And then in the summer, they go big game hunting, whether it's Jimmy Butler, whether you go Kawhi Leonard.
You're making my point. And they're throwing away a year because basketball is not the center of his universe. And the LeBron in Cleveland the first time, the LeBron in Miami, the LeBron that went back to Cleveland. As Rich Paul just said, it was all about basketball and winning and championships. But, you know, now he didn't have his footing. He just wanted to be happy. He's out to dinner with DiCaprio and Pacino.
What did he do after that dinner, though?
He's mad he didn't get the invite. Come on, man. Listen.
What did he do after the dinner?
He got on Instagram and started working out.
He was on Instagram working out.
Yes.
This is just like a movie franchise, okay? It's just like a movie franchise. And the first one was the story, like Rocky. Yeah, that was the best of the movies. There's Rocky 2. Rocky 3.
Glad you made this analogy. Okay. Continue. Continue to hang yourself.
No. But Rocky 4.
Rocky 4 was amazing.
Might not have been as good a movie as Rocky was, but Rocco still pulled it out. Okay, he dominated the Russian, and Drago, who killed his friend, ended up
what happened with Rocky when he became a celebrity and became famous. He got fat and lazy.
He did.
And
he started training young guys.
Mick had to, you know, really pull. And it's
but then at the end, he was champion of the world.
Yes.
Rocco pulled this one out. I'm sorry, was that a spoiler? Did I ruin that for people?
He's 34
you ain't
years
it by
old.
Now, you're just...
Yeah, he's 34 years old come December. He'll be starting his 16th season. He knows, y'all not willing to admit it. He's not even willing to admit it. His best days are behind him.
I agree with
his
you.
His best days are behind
yes.
him.
Yes.
And he's thinking about other things beyond basketball. And I'm saying the expectation of Laker fans is going to be championship contention. And consistently. And I just don't think that's a priority
just
for LeBron.
If LeBron gets in the playoff, like, is that a puncher's chance? Is that a fighter's chance?
Of course.
That's the same thing you would have said in the Eastern Conference last year. Look what he did.
Okay, so tell me what would have been better, to stay in Cleveland with that mess? To go to Philadelphia where they lost the shooters. And by the way, out west.
I'm not saying I would have made a different choice. I'm just trying to set reasonable expectations for what's about to happen.
Playoffs. This year, playoffs.
And it will be a disappointment because people are. Look, even if they back into the playoffs this year, Utah, Oklahoma City, the way this team's currently constructed, you know, you three and with me coaching would have a shot because these guys can't shoot. Doug Gottlieb can damn near shoot as well as half these guys they've
signed. You know what he did with the last roster like that? He took them to the finals.
Those guys could shoot.
But they couldn't go by anybody or guard anybody. Yeah. Okay, listen, you're looking at a stationary target. The Lakers last year, Brandon Ingram, just 20 years old. Is he going to get better? Of course he is. Kyle Kuzma's first year. Is he going to get better his second year? Of course he is. Josh Hart, is he going to get better? Of course he is. And then you have the older guys who come in off the bench and give you grittiness and toughness and the ability to guard different positions. That's the plan.
You ever seen Fat Elvis?
Huh?
Did you ever see Fat Elvis?
I did see Fat Elvis.
That's what we're about to see.
Okay, but he's not Fat Elvis.
That's what we're about to see.
34-9-9.
It's going to look different. Year four of the contract, maybe. Year four.
It's going to look different. He'll be in shape. The abs will be packed. But it's going to be Fat Elvis. I've seen people. L.A. is where you come. When you've made all that money, you come here to retire and shut it down. And to kick it and have a good time.
This is not Florida. That's
he's
Florida.
Different. You come here to make the seamless transition.